So with us tonight, DirtFish fans, we have a genuine Swedish rally legend, Mr. Stig Blomqvist. Good evening, Stig.
Good evening.
So, where to start? You won this event 5 times. Can you even remember how many times have you started this rally?
I don't know exactly, but it'd be close to 40, I think.
It's incredible. I think your first international win in 71 came here. I mean, what's your best memory of this rally?
Nah, but okay, it's your home event. It's always nice to do, and especially in the days when we had proper winter and nice roads and lot of snow, that was really good.
And you're from Karlstad, if I'm right in thinking, or brought up in Karlstad. It's incredible now to think that we used to compete on the lake and the river through Karlstad as well.
Okay, in the beginning we did about 100 kilometers better stage on the river up here, so that was, then it was proper winter.
Yeah, it is an amazing event. How can you ever remember, obviously the conditions we've seen here are fairly exceptional, but can you ever remember seeing a winter, maybe 1990, because it was cancelled, wasn't it, in 90?
It was cancelled once, but okay, we have had, okay, not completely like this maybe, but we have had quite a few stages like this in the old days as well. But okay, then the rally was further south. But so it's nothing new really. It could happen even in the old days. Yeah.
I want to take you back to one of my favorite Swedish results for you. Back to 1983 when you drove the Audi 80 Quattro. I remember I was a little fella, but I remember seeing you in that car, which it was a non-turbo car. And you finished second. And it was, for me, it was an incredible drive. What do you think?
But I think what you said, I think that was one of my best drive here in Swedish Rally, because the car was very much under power. But the car was, because of that, it was quite easy to drive. But, okay, I was pushing quite hard because you want to do good with that car as well, because you was a bit disappointed to be in that car, actually. But still, the result was quite good.
It was a funny year, that, in 83, because Audi made it very clear who they wanted to win the championship, and really that was Mikkola's year. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I think it's quite fair to say, because he had this year already, 82, but then he had too many problems, so then he got another year.
Yeah. You had 1 year in 84, and you certainly took advantage of that with the World Championship. Tell us a memory from that season.
Okay, it was quite a tough start, because then for 84 Audi signed Walter Röhl as well, so have him in the team, but he didn't want to do the whole championship, and then he was an incredible sportsman, so when it was any problem, the rally we did together, I always get the favor, because he said he was not doing for the championship, so he was really good like that. But okay, it was quite tough anyway, because it was to be there, and the Lancia was very competitive, so we had them to fight with as well.
And we shouldn't forget, of course, one year, maybe more than 1 year, you drove a Stratos here as well.
Yeah, I drove the Stratos here in 78.
And you come not long after, before that, sorry, you'd been driving the Saab, the 96. How on earth did that car differ from the Saab?
Yeah, it was, okay, big difference, but okay, the car was very nice to drive, actually. It was much easier than most people wanted to say about the car. Yeah. So I didn't feel bad, because it was a bit unlucky, but still we had some good results with the car.
Yeah. And let's bring ourselves right up to date now. What has been your impression of what you've seen today?
It's incredible, the speed I have today. It's really incredible to see the cars. So, okay, the cars are really good, but okay, the drivers have to drive them as well. So it's really tough.
But you talk about that, Stig, but you know, I mean, you look back at the bravery that you showed when you drove these Group B cars. You know, the Sport Quattro in particular here must have been such a handful, so difficult to drive.
Yeah, quite difficult to drive, but okay, that means the corner speed was not that high at all, because it was quick between the corner, but then you have to try to get around the corner.
Yeah. And what about Sunday afternoon, who, in your opinion, who are we going to see standing on top of the podium?
I don't know, really. It's quite difficult, but it should be nice if Evans can do it, especially for his dad, because he was so close to get good with the Ford and thing, but he never really made it. But now he get it back from the sun, I hope.
Do you would have been in the Ford team 87, maybe. You drove the four-wheel drive Sierra, the XR 4x4. Was Gwynneth around with Ford then?
Yeah, he was around, and he did the British Championship, and he did a little bit for them. But Ford never really did him any good, really, because he got some rallies, but he never got any proper program, really.
That's right. I'd forgotten you did a season in Skoda with the BRC, didn't you?
Yeah, I did that as well, yeah.
It is incredible. And obviously second last year on the Safari. Are we going to see you out anymore? Any more plans to come back?
Not Safari, because that's quite tough to do that. But I should do the Midnight Sun in Sweden again, just for doing something. But Safari, I think it's enough now.
And final question now. You're a man who will know. We hear there may be some snow coming tonight. What do you think?
Okay, I don't know. If it comes something, it will not be much anyway. But I think if it comes a bit snow, then it depends whether you are on the road tomorrow morning then.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much, Stig. There we go. That is a genuine legend. 5-time Swedish Rally winner, Stig Blomqvist.